everybody, it's me, Chris. It's been a very long time since I last made a video, and I've been busy. So, I don't really know where to start. I have obviously purchased a lot of dolls. I've picked up a lot of dolls along the way. I've just been... I've just been busy, I guess. So, part of my being away has just been emotionally. I can't really... I don't even know how to explain this, really. It's just... I go through bouts of depression, and then I can't really deal with the online aspect of collecting. So I kind of refocus onto other things, and I've just been... I guess I've just been emotionally drained, and I can't do both. So I just figured, since it has been such a long time, I would just kind of try to get back into it, I guess, and redirect emotions and stuff into dolls again. It's not like I've been taking a break from dolls. I've just been taking more so a break from the social media aspect of dolls. I recently have created a Instagram account for my dolls. You can find it on Instagram if you look up Doll Dirt, which is the same as my Tumblr, which is Doll Dirt. What am I going to talk about today? Well, I do have some dolls I want to unbox, and I figured I would do that on camera. So I guess I could do that, but I've also got some other dolls that I've picked up and have been sent to me, and maybe I'll start there. So a little while ago, me and John kind of decided to do a trade because he had a doll head that I really, really, really wanted. It's been on my wish list for a few years now, and he also had a original Superstar Barbie from 1977. Which I've been wanting for a very long time as well. So as far as Superstar Barbie goes, I've always loved the Superstar Barbie sculpt. It's a sculpt I grew up with as a child, and they were using it for over 20 years, I think. So to have the original Superstar Barbie was awesome. To be able to own the original Superstar Barbie is great. Like, I love this doll. I think she's the pinnacle of superstardom. I actually put her on I think this is a karate made to move. And I feel like the match is pretty good. John sent me her original head, her necklace, her dress. And I was able to complete her. And funnily enough, I was able to find another one thrifting literally the day after John sent me this one. So I kept her on her original body, and I actually straightened her hair a little bit to clean her up some to make them different, but still the same. I'm not actually sure what dress she's wearing, but it is super starry, so she is keeping it. This is actually the dress she came with and the feather thing. And I think she cleaned up really well. As far as their faces go, they are very similar. Slight differences. This one is a little darker skin tone for some reason. But they are the same doll. But I also have Beautiful Bride, who uses the same makeup and everything as Superstar, and they're pretty much the same. So I'm almost wondering if this one is also Beautiful Bride and that one is actually Superstar. I'm not actually sure, but these two look closer than the two Superstars do. So it might be two Beautiful Brides, but they are very similar that I can still consider this one Superstar. Another doll head that John sent me was actually a funny story. I found this doll on eBay who was mislabeled, and she was a Superstar doll, but she had brown hair and I want to say more modern makeup. So I thought maybe she was a holiday doll, and I had all of my Flickr and Tumblr friends trying to ID this doll, and I just could not find her. And eventually, I forget who ID'd her, but they ID'd her as an American Pioneer second edition doll, which by looking at her face, you wouldn't really think that's the face of a Pioneer, but what do I know? Mattel is weird like that with makeup sometimes. So when John found this doll thrifting, he immediately picked her up and he sent her to me, and she is great. I have very few brunette superstar dolls, even though they've made a ton of them over the years. I guess I'm a little bit more picky when it comes to superstars, but she has a beautiful face, perfect eyes, and I just knew I had to have her in my collection. And it was just funny because he found this doll and I was like in the middle of trying to find her on eBay for a reasonable price. So it was just great that he was able to send me this head. And I've actually rebodied her onto a made to move, because that's kind of what I do with my dolls these days, is I rebody them all into made to move bodies. But yeah, anyway, she is really great. I'm rambling really fast. So John actually sent me a ton of doll heads, and I'm only going to show you a few in this video just because there are so many. And I could just literally make like probably an hour long video of just all the doll heads he sent me and what I've done with them. But I'm just mostly focusing on the main core ones that I was really super excited about, just to kind of keep it shorter, because I do still want to open all these boxes. There's two boxes. So anyway, the last doll that has been on my wish list forever, forever being 2013, is an Integrity Toys Style Lab Laco Orion. And he sent me the head because he bought a head lot, and this one has a smell issue. She smells like smoke. And it doesn't really bother me because I have treated her, but she does still smell like smoke, but it's not as bad as it was when he first sent her. So she is gorgeous. And I've been wanting this doll for so long, and I was just never able to find her at a reasonable price. And now you can't really find her at all from what I've been finding online. So I'm so, so happy that he actually agreed to send me this doll. And this is the doll head that I actually agreed to do the trade for. And so, yeah. So I haven't really been enjoying her. She's been kind of being treated for smell and just, I guess, yeah. But she actually ended up with Gem and the Holograms Jerrica's body, which is just a color infusion body similar to the one she would have originally came with. And Jerrica has been since rebodied to a made-to-move body because that's my go-to. And it looks like I just got a message of some sort. Joys of recording with your phone. But yeah, so this doll is a huge favorite of mine right now, and she's getting a lot of love. So yeah, I guess on to the box openings. So since I've been off from work, I went to London with my sister, and we went to a Toys R Us. Where I'm from, we don't have a Toys R Us, so I have very limited places I can go to get dolls. Which is why I think most of my dolls are thrifted or from Amazon. So when I went shopping, I ended up picking up the Barbie Look Poolside Chic. And I've been wanting this doll, I don't want to say since she was promoed, because I was originally skeptical, I think, on her face, just because the way Sweet Tea turned out, she had a weird eye. But this doll is probably going to pick up her glare or something. But yeah, she's just beautiful. She uses the Carl sculpt, and I was just really excited to find her. They only had one at this Toys R Us, The rest were all Urban Jungle, and I literally took every doll off the shelf looking for just this one. So yeah, I was super glad to have her. I immediately scooped her up just because I knew she had to come home with me. The other doll that I ended up getting was actually a gift from my sister, who is amazing. I love my sister. Is the reproduction of Totally Hair Barbie, which this was a huge childhood doll of mine, a doll that I never actually owned, but anytime I went to a friend's house and they had this doll, I would immediately lay claim to her and she would be the one I would play with. But so yeah, this was a gift for my sister and I'm super glad to have her, and I'm really excited to open her just because I want to see basically the quality difference, I guess. Just because the only other... I own three of the original Totally Hair Barbies, but they've all been varying degrees of quality. One was originally new in box when I got her. She was a gift from my friend Natasha. Then the other two I thrifted. One has since been rerouted. But yeah, one of the interesting things I found with this doll is they didn't include the original Depp gel, which I don't know if Depp is still a company, but they could have included, I don't know, just some other type of hairstyling product, I guess. Unless, well, obviously this isn't geared more towards children, it's more towards nostalgia collectors. But, yeah, I was kind of bummed that that was left out. So anyway, I guess I will start with Totally Hair. Okay, so I'm going to try and do this up here instead of down here, just because I don't want to reposition the camera. Oh dear. So anyway, I have my handy dandy doll opening tools. I have an X-Acto knife to cut things, and I have these to pull the plastic things out of her head, because they're always in their heads. Cut the tape. And I should probably close the blade so I don't stab myself in the face. As much fun as that would be. Okay. It's actually been a really long time since I opened the original doll that I don't know how much the packaging actually compares, but there's probably another review on YouTube somewhere comparing the two boxes. So far everything is pretty smooth going. She slides right out of the outer box. Rubber leg, which is cool. So she does come with all of her other stuff. She just doesn't come with the gel. And her face is actually pretty... Well, same color palette anyway, but it is a different style. Different styling than the original. I'll have to go grab one of my original ones just so I can compare the two, but... Other than that, pretty similar. I'm gonna get her out now. If I can. I don't know where that connects. Okay, so interestingly enough, she, for the most part, slides right out. Like, if I would have been a little bit more patient, I probably could have undone all of these eyes. And she does have the original shoes, the original shoe mold. They haven't changed that at all, which is awesome. Let's see if I can get this out. I'm fighting with her feet, by the way. I know I said I would do it up high, but having her on a flat surface, I'm sure, is helping me greatly. There we go. So we have two feet. Two feet. just so you know, I'm not lying. Okay, now let's see. Okay, so she is in here with giant plastic things. And I don't know where they just went. All over the floor. Perfect. Clean it up after. Ow. Okay, so now to figure out how to get her hair out. It is sewn into the box. And I lost a shoe. I also find it interesting that she's actually wearing the shoes and they're not packaged in a baggie. Because I think that's how they used to do it. Okay, her hair is really super soft. I don't know what it's made out of, but it is really super soft, which is freaking awesome. If I can get her out. It is sewn to her hair. Release. Okay. She's free from her box prison. Oh my gosh, is this soft. So yeah, don't mind me, I'm just appreciating, I guess. Okay, so I'm not really one for crimped hair, but this is really pretty crimped hair. Like, I think her head is actually a different color than her body, which is weird. Okay, so here is totally hair Barbie out of her box. And look at that hair. Whoosh, 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 whoosh. This is really nice hair. Oh, I actually love her a lot more than I thought I would. This is awesome. And I really do have to go get the other one just to compare them because I want to see what they've changed. Well, other than her bangs. Which are rooted super weird, by the way. I don't want to take her headband off, but I can lift them up. They are rooted super far back. Hopefully I'm in frame, but hopefully you can see that. Yeah, I don't get that at all. I guess that means I can unroot them super easily, but I think she is actually going to stay like this and not get redressed or anything. She will be display only. But yeah, that's a weird observation so far. I guess I'll get the rest of her stuff out and then I will go get the other one and compare if I can figure out how to get these out. Okay, so these are sewn in as well. Okay, they're mixed sewn in and elastic. Okay, so we have this thing, which I never have understood what this is for. Even growing up, I never understood what this was for. I know you wrap it around her hair and do stuff with it, but I think the original one had a wire in it, and this one doesn't. So I think it's just supposed to be a tie, maybe? A tie? I don't know. She's got her comb. Well, I guess it's a pick. And if I can get this out. Get it. A shoelace thing. Bonk. air puff number one. Don't need the knife for this. Hair pop number two. When I was a kid, I used to pretend these were pom-poms. Go team. And last but not least, we got a pamphlet for 25th anniversary. And a piece of cardboard. Oh, this is cool. It's like literally the original style guide to give you ideas. And on the inside it's got kind of like a history of Totally Hair Barbie with an illustration. That is pretty cool. I will read this later. Yeah, I'll read this later. I'm not going to read it now. That is a cool bit of packaging. But as far for the rest of her box, there's not really much to it. There's not really much to her box. It's literally just polka dots. The only thing I have to get out of here is her stand. I didn't even know she had one. I love how Mattel does this. They always crumple up the certificate of authenticity, which I feel like devalues the whole thing, but whatever. I guess they just assume you'll never open it and never look. There we go. So there she is. Totally Hair Barbie. On her stand without any of her stuff in her hair yet, because I have not played with her that much, obviously, because you just watched me. But overall, I feel like she is pretty accurate to the original Totally Hair Barbie. I am just gonna go grab the original Totally Hair Barbie. Okay, so this is my original Totally Hair Barbie that I got in box. Her hair is straightened, so she is a little different than this Totally Hair Barbie. But yeah, their eye makeup is drastically different as far as the styling goes. Hopefully they're in frame. Hopefully they're close enough that you can see them. I don't know. I know there was a few different versions of this Totally Hair Barbie, so I don't know if it's just like a factory difference and then this one is closer to one of the versions. I don't remember which one this is. I don't remember if she's China or Malaysia. Anyway. Yeah, but this one definitely has darker eye makeup with thicker lashes than this one, but the overall look is very similar. This one does have darker brows. This one has very light brows. So that's different. I don't know, like, just looking at them like this, they don't even look like the same doll. Like, the faces look completely different. That's interesting. But yeah, at least she has the feel of Totally Hair Barbie. Okay, so do you know how I mentioned the bangs on the new one are really far back? This one's bangs start literally at her root line. So, I don't know why they made that change. I don't know how weird it would look if you restyled her hair. I'm gonna have to look up owner picks and see how people deal with that, or if I just have a weird one. I'm gonna have to check that. So next up, I'm going to be unboxing Poolside Chic. Woo! And here we go. I don't know how exciting this is to watch me open boxes, but I'm enjoying it. So hopefully you are at least getting a little bit of enjoyment out of this as well. Okay, so the camera stopped recording, so I just restarted it. And luckily I didn't miss anything. Ta-da. So overall, her packaging is pretty nice. She came out of the box pretty smoothly. Oddly enough, after I complained about the certificate of authenticity being all wrinkled and stuff, this one seems fine. So thanks for listening, Mattel. That's too funny. The only thing I don't like about this certificate is it doesn't tell you which doll you got. It just says you bought a Barbie the Look doll. And I don't have Urban Jungle to compare the certificates to see how different they are, but let's get on to the more exciting stuff, which is getting her out of this box prison without wrecking her. Because this dress looks very delicate. I guess sheer fabrics usually are. Okay, so the dress bottom came out. Let's see how the rest goes, if at all. Oh my god! Come out! Okay, I'm just cutting her out at this point, just because I cannot work these elastics up enough to pull her legs out. That's interesting. So she has made-to-move knees. That's interesting. But she doesn't have the thighs or the ankles, just the knees. And then her arms look like they're fashionista arms. If I can get her free, I will show you. It's screwing her up. Okay, so Totally Hair Barbie came out a lot easier than this. This is kind of a train wreck. Okay, not a train wreck, but definitely a lot more challenging for some reason. She should be fastened by her waist, but I can't find... Oh, there it is. It's in her dress. Okie dokie. And release her pen. Okay, so her hair is sewn to the box. I don't want to wreck her curls. There we go. She is really pretty. Her hair is super flat, but she is really pretty. Super flat. Oh boy. Oh, I'm gonna have to wreck her curls and wash her hair. That sucks. But yeah, she does just have regular Fashionista arms with fashionista hands. Carl sculpt, of course. Feels like, I don't want to undress her on camera, but it feels like a pivotal torso. With the upper part of her legs is definitely fashionista mold. This is a really nice dress. It has potential to be slit a lot higher than it actually is if they put a stitch in here for modesty. Modesty stitch. Okay. I'm just going to get the rest of her stuff out, I guess. So the rest of her stuff looks like it includes a stand and a phone, lipstick, compact, and maybe a purse. Might be a purse. See how easily this pops out. Lord knows she was a challenge. Derp. Bear derp. Release. Release. So we have a compact with no mirror in it. Just a compact. Doesn't stay closed, but that's okay. What's next? Purse? Well, it's a clutch, I guess. And it does open. Clutch does open. Does stay shut. Release. Lost it. Come back. Okay, so we got the phone out, which has a very tiny screenshot of the Barbie Instagram account. That is cute. It's also very thin. I'll probably lose that. And I cannot get this last thing out. It feels like it's built into the plastic. I'm just going to cut it out. There we go. So it is tiny lipstick. Super tiny lipstick. That is cute. That is really cute. And last but not least, the stand. Oh, that broke. Great. Yeah. Okay, so we do have a different type of stand. This is the kind that grips at the waist versus the thighs. And I dropped it. Okay, this stand really sucks. This thing does not slide. Or want to slide. Okay, so there is Poolside Chic on her stand. And overall, I'm really impressed with the doll itself. Not so much with the accessories. But that's fine. I didn't really care about the accessories anyway. The only thing I wish they would have done is give her made-to-move elbows as well. Just because that is literally the extent of her motion. 90 degrees. she may actually get rebodied onto a different body, just because I've been pretty spoiled by Made to Move, and I can't handle that. Like, she can't even touch her face. But yeah, for a collector doll, she is really, really beautiful, really impressive, and I would recommend picking her up. I would also recommend picking up Totally Hair Barbie if you're into that nostalgia niche, like I am. Not 100% accurate, but still really pretty. So, yay. I feel like I'm out of frame. I probably am. I probably recorded most of that out of frame. Knocked everybody over. But, yay! New dolls. Oh, also, last but not least, I've also been thrifting dolls still, and I recently picked up this Disney Store Aurora, who is basically brand new. Like, she even has her shoes still elastic to her feet, and she has her necklace elastic to her neck. All I did was kind of cleaned up her hair, which did get rid of the factory gel that was in it, so it is kind of a little messy still, but definitely a lot better than when I found her, because she did look pretty ratty. But yeah, this is the only doll I'm going to show you that I thrifted recently, just because, not that there's a lot, but I didn't really do much with them other than clean them up and kind of store them, just because they were dolls I've been wanting, but I don't have any appropriate clothes for them. Because I have been actually finding quite a few gem dolls, which is awesome, because I kind of missed out on that whole era of gem dolls, just because I was born the year they came out, or the year after. I don't remember if they came out in 84 or 85. Anyway, so Aurora, my favorite Disney princess, I finally have her doll. But yeah, I'm going to wrap this up, I think. Unless there was something else I wanted to talk about. Oh. When I went shopping in London, I did pick up some Citadel paints, just because I have been wanting more Citadel paints, because I really like the quality of them, and they're great for repainting dolls. Basing this all on the fact that I've bought one little pot so far before this, which is Screaming Skull, which is a fairly decent match to some Barbie skin tones, actually. So, it's been a pretty handy little pot to have. And I have used, I want to say, the majority of this pot already. It hasn't gone, they don't go very far. Let's just put it that way. But I have done a few body repaints with this. And I do need to pick up another one. I just didn't realize how much I had left. So as far as the other colors go, I did get just a basic ceramic white. I figure it would be good for doing eyes. And a black. I'm like, what is the name? Anyway, I'm not even going to try to say it. It is a black. I figured that'd be good for eyeliner and lashes. I figured I would try just to stick with basic things for now and build it up from there. Just because I've been told these don't last very long in the pot after you open them. And the last thing I want to do is spend... Well, these ones were only $5 because I did get them directly from Games Workshop in the actual store. So that's more reasonable. It's just if I buy them more locally, I think they are a few dollars more. So I don't want to spend a few dollars more for dried up paint if I don't end up using it. So the other color I ended up getting was Karak Stone, which was in with the flesh tones, but I don't think this is actually considered a flesh tone. And I thought it might be close to, what am I thinking of, action figure colors or action figure tone. So action figures, I'm just gonna grab John Cena here. This isn't actually John Cena, by the way. It's like an Air Force pilot head of some type. I don't remember who, maybe Soldier Story. I might have just made that up. So anyway, they're more of like a gray sort of undertone to their skin when you compare them to, I don't know, Barbie, who is more warmer tone. Using this as an example, not knowing which tone she actually is, because I just caught her and I haven't compared her to anything, but she looks like she is probably more so the newer karate made to move tone. At least her head is anyway. Her body might be closer to the blue top made to move. But if you look at the tones, totally different. And I'll pick up her stand now. But as far as this paint goes, I thought it would be close. So I painted a Barbie swapping style bust just to kind of get an idea for the size of it, I guess. But actually looking at the two, it could probably pass, but it's not 100%. I don't even know if you can see this. I'll probably have to take a picture and put it on my Flickr. But, yeah, they're similar, but they're not 100%. Ideally, my thought process with finding these flesh-tone Citadel paints is a more readily available source for skin tone matching. That way, because I really like articulation, but I also don't mind painting things to match. So if I could find these in very similar tones to pre-existing dolls, it would definitely make body swapping a lot more easier, or a lot easier for me anyway. I was actually wondering how close this paint color would be to Integrity dolls, because they are all, I'm just throwing everything, they're also sometimes grayish, but it's not close at all. It's way too dark. I might be able to tone it down a bit and actually paint something to match, but a lot of these heads match the newer Barbie tones anyway, decently enough that you don't have to tweak them that much. So, yeah, part of me is kind of like, okay, I spent $5 on this and I'm never going to get any use out of it, but I probably can mix it with something to get it closer to actual tones I want to match. So it won't be a complete loss, I guess. It just kind of didn't work out so well for getting ideally matched paints. I wish they had more so a accurate color chart, I should say, to actually get colors closer, because all they have is printed material, and I know you can never trust printed material for being an exact color representation. I get this all the time, especially at work, when people are trying to buy things off of printed material and they get it and they're like, ooh, that's more orange, or ooh, that's more black. So I wish they had an actual swatch of the paint to give you a better representation of the color. Because in the store, this looked like it would match Barbie pretty well, but obviously in person, it doesn't get anywhere close. So I think my goal is to be, or going to be, to pick up more Citadel paints in flesh tones and see what I can come up with as far as matching dolls. Or if anybody else out there has an actual, these paints already and can do a comparison for me, that'd be great. Save me money and time if you've already done it. So I'm surprised I haven't actually been able to find something like that online, but maybe I'm not digging in the right places. So yeah, that completes my purchasing update, I guess. Hopefully this wasn't too boring for everyone watching. I'm not going to promise that I'm going to make more videos anytime soon, because realistically I can't guarantee anything. But anyway, hopefully you enjoyed watching. I will try my best to make another one, but like I said, no promises at all. But that wraps it up, and I will talk to you all later. Bye!